Hello and welcome to In Depth. I'm Tina Jha. On the 16th of January 2016, Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched the Startup India Action Plan with an aim to build a strong ecosystem for nurturing innovation and startups in the country. 5 years on, India has transformed into a big startup ecosystem in the world. The government has been working towards recognizing the real potential of startups operating across diverse segments. Accordingly, policies have been formulated to create a conducive, favorable environment for them. The government's focus has been on three C's: capital, courage, and connections, which Prime Minister Modi describes as the main prerequisites for setting up any business. Due to this, there has been a significant rise in the number of entrepreneurs, particularly from Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities of the country. The participation of women has also increased under the Startup India program. Today, In Depth analyzes the entrepreneurial movement in the country since the launch of the Startup India program, the progress that the scheme has made since its inception in 2016, and the road ahead.
Prarambh, the two-day-long Startup India International Summit, kicked off in the national capital on Friday. The summit marks the fifth anniversary of the Startup India initiative, launched by the Prime Minister on 16th January 2016. With participation from over 25 countries and more than 200 global speakers, the summit is the largest startup confluence organized by the government since the launch of the Startup India program. At the inauguration, Union Minister Piyush Goyal said the startup collaborations in the country have a huge potential as new ideas will lead to innovation and invention. Goyal added that today's young generation have an immense entrepreneurial streak as they look to be job creators instead of job seekers. The minister also invited startups from neighboring South Asian countries to come together and collaborate. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will interact with startups and address the event on Saturday. The two-day event will witness 24 sessions with a focus on enhancing multilateral cooperation and engagement with countries from around the globe to collectively develop and strengthen the startup ecosystems.
In the past 5 years, the Startup India initiative has helped many young entrepreneurs to start their own ventures and also succeed. Under the scheme, financial help is given to those who wish to start a business, and at the same time, they are given a tax rebate. Apart from this, the government offers several other types of exemptions under the Startup India program. In this report, let's try and understand the advantages associated with the Startup India initiative.
The idea behind the government's Startup India program in January 2016 was to create employment opportunities for the youth in the country. For this, the government also announced several concessions for new entrepreneurs under the Startup India program. These included an exemption from income tax on profits earned in the first 3 years of starting the business. In order to promote financing, the sale of their property was to be exempted from the capital gains tax of 20%. Under this, a provision for a liberal patent for new enterprises was also made. Other benefits included reduction in patent registration fees by 80%. Apart from this, if an entrepreneur wanted to leave the business, he or she could shut down the startup in a 90-day period. Innovation courses were started for students under the Startup India program, wherein the focus is on having 10 lakh students in 5 lakh schools. Exceptions have also been made for government purchases under Startup India.
Government has created a situation where if an entrepreneur can get a startup recognized, a whole slew of benefits come to him. He need not go anywhere. He gets all his clearances. And most important, he is also eligible for self-certification. He need not go to some government regulatory agency and seek certification and approvals. He self-certifies himself. So all this red tape is cut off, and moreover, once your unit is recognized as a startup by the appropriate authority, you can approach the Small Industries Development Bank of India for loans, Hundreds of projects have now been given loans, huge funding for startups.
However, to take advantage of Startup India, it is necessary to meet the criteria set by the government. On a priority, it is mandatory to tell the number of jobs that would be created from a new startup.
Major benefits are that they can start their venture with the innovative idea. If they have some idea, then they can implement in the market and they can start a business. And government is providing the support of tax exemption, like in this block of 7 years, they are exempted for the profits for the 3 years. So that is the major benefit, that they are not burdened with the tax environment at the time of their implementation of idea. That is number one. And number two, there is fund for startups. That is also very, very important for the startups, that government is providing a fund allocation that is for the startups to benefit them and to support them in their business ventures. That is the support from the government. And third is the ease of doing business, that the government is undertaking a lot of reforms for the startups, like a single window system and their registration in few seconds. That is the facilitation from the government side, that the persons with the innovative ideas should grow and contribute significantly in the economic growth of India.
The role of states in implementing Startup India is also vital. With the center giving priority to Startup India, at present 26 states are running the startup scheme and the remaining states and union territories are working to introduce the program. An important role of the states is to reduce the regulatory burden on the startup founders, which can be promoted by simplifying the rules under the jurisdiction of the state. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced the government's flagship Startup India initiative from the ramparts of the Red Fort on 15th August 2015. On 16th January 2016, the Startup India Action Plan was launched. Since then, success stories of several young entrepreneurs have been scripted in the country, with the government providing them a simplified process, hand-holding and also incentives.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi proclaimed the Startup India campaign in 2016 to boost entrepreneurship in India. The program has achieved considerable success in the last 5 years, with the government providing several benefits to startups in the form of tax cuts, easy license clearances and lesser regulatory interference. Since the launch of the program on 16th January 2016, several programs have been undertaken to transform India into a country of job creators instead of job seekers.
Government started this startup move 3 years ago. That is very fruitful and beneficial for the economy, because we have to increase the participation of startups and small businesses in our economic growth, which is not at at a comfortable position right now, because our MSME's contribution is only 31-32% in the overall GDP. But in other economies, like in advanced economies, the contribution is more than sometimes 70% or 80%. So with this startups program, now they will be able to start their ventures independently, and they can implement their innovative ideas. And there are a lot of schemes, beneficial schemes for these startups, and they are growing up, and the number is the fruit number is increasing, and they are getting the fruitful results from the startups program.
First of all, the scope of startups has been widened. An entity shall be considered as a startup for up to 7 years instead of the earlier 5 years, and a biotechnology startup for up to 10 years. This has been done acknowledging the long gestation period for startups. The scope has been broadened to include scalable business models with high potential of employment generation or wealth creation. Additionally, no letter of recommendation from an incubator or industry association shall be required for either recognition or tax benefits. In order to create a conducive ecosystem for the growth of startups and provide them an equal platform vis-a-vis the experienced entrepreneurs or companies in public procurement, relaxed norms of public procurement for micro and small enterprises have been provisioned in the procurement policy of Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. Compliance norms have been eased in order to reduce the regulatory burden on startups, allowing them to focus on their core business. Startup India Hub was operationalized on 1st April 2016 to resolve queries and provide hand-holding support to the startups. Certain tax exemptions were also given to the startups. The Finance Act 2016 had made provision for the startups to get income tax exemption for 3 years in a block of 5 years if they are incorporated between 1st April 2016 and 31st March 2019.
So in India, especially after the Prime Minister's scheme, we've been able to get into a lot of PSUs being a young startup. We've been able to work with Apple, also been able to work with the nuclear power plants here. So that way, I think the ecosystem is growing quite well in this country right now. But the policies are one, the DIP process has actually eased our taxations, GSTs, or even the other registration process with governments. It's been much quicker here. So one, we want more taxation benefits for startups. And second, when a startup is competing with a bigger company, like which is much more established, there should be some sort of policy drafted which supports startups, because we need more opportunities and chances, and definitely the government has to support us in this.
They're really doing good. What I would say, they need to provide, in terms of help, in terms of money, monetary related, more fund, and, be open to the new idea where they may have to change a couple of policies.
Atal Tinkering Labs by the Atal Innovation Mission also aims to inculcate entrepreneurial skills in school students. Over 14,000 schools were selected to set up these labs, out of which nearly 5,400 are fully operational as of date, enabling over 2.5 million students between grade 6 to grade 12 to advanced emerging tinkering DIY technologies and creating a problem-solving and innovative mindset. New incubation centers are being established under the Atal Innovation Mission across India through financial support. The incubators will provide necessary infrastructure and assistance to startups in their early stages of growth. 8 research parks are also being set up under the Startup India initiative, with an objective to propel successful innovation through incubation and joint research and development efforts between academia and industry. Since its inception, 26 states have formulated startup policies. And to foster competitiveness among them, State Startup Ranking Framework was launched in February 2018, based on which states are working proactively to promote their startup ecosystems. The ranking was released in December 2018. In January 2019, the country's largest startup ecosystem was inaugurated in Kerala. The 1.8 lakh square feet facility houses incubation setups across a string of segments in modern technology. The integrated startup complex under the Kerala Startup Mission includes the ultra-modern facilities of Maker Village that promotes hardware startups, the BioNest that promotes medical technologies, Brink, which is the country's first international accelerator for hardware startups, Brick, which aids developing solutions for cancer diagnosis and care, and a center for excellence. The Maker Village, set up by the IIITMK in association with Kerala Startup Mission and supported by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, houses 65 startups working in electronics hardware technologies. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Startup India has crossed the 40,000 mark for startups recognized by the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, which offer services in various sectors like IT, technology, hardware, healthcare, agriculture, education, food, and renewable energy. Today, Gujarat is the best state in the country for startups, while the top performing states in the year 2019 were Karnataka and Kerala. In this report, let's take a look at how the states are faring in terms of startup ecosystems.
The second edition of the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade State Startup Rankings for the year 2019 were announced in September 2020. The key objective of the exercise was to foster competitiveness and propel states to work proactively towards uplifting the startup ecosystem. An evaluation committee comprising independent experts from the startup ecosystem carried out a detailed assessment of responses across various parameters. The competition saw a participation of 22 states and 3 union territories. While Gujarat and Andaman and Nicobar Islands were adjudged best performance, Kerala and Karnataka were awarded top performers. In the leaders category, Bihar, Maharashtra, Odisha, Rajasthan and Chandigarh emerged as the top 5 states, while Haryana, Jharkhand, Punjab, Telangana and Uttarakhand were adjudged top states in the aspiring leaders category. In the emerging startup ecosystem, Andhra Pradesh, Assam, Chhattisgarh, Delhi, Himachal Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Sikkim, Tamil Nadu and Uttar Pradesh emerged as the top states. The participating states were awarded points according to performances across 7 categories, consisting of 30 action points ranging from institutional support, easing compliances, relaxation in public procurement norms, incubation support, seed funding support, venture funding support, and awareness and outreach. India is home to over 50,000 startups with over 30 unicorns. According to a report, India will see 100 unicorns by 2025 that will help create over 1.1 million direct jobs. The state startup ranking exercise was started by the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade in 2018 to help in capacity building of states and build a robust startup ecosystem for nurturing innovation and providing opportunities to budding entrepreneurs. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
The Startup India scheme has new policies and initiatives to make it easier for investors and startup founders to incubate their ventures in the country. Here's a look at how the scheme has helped and encouraged young entrepreneurs to transform their innovative ideas into profitable business ventures.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Startup India has put India at number 3 in world rankings. Several programs have been undertaken since the launch of the initiative to transform India into a country of job creators instead of job seekers. Startup India is a flagship initiative of the government intended to build a strong ecosystem conducive for the growth of startup businesses.
It is an integral part of making India to create employment and also help our youth and other young entrepreneurs that you can do things right here in India. You don't have to be frustrated and you don't have to work for a giant company. You start your own unit. And we have already seen the results. There are so many companies which are startups which have now become huge market forces, huge market capitalization has taken place.
It is a platform that provides opportunities for youth to become industrialists and entrepreneurs. Under this, the government grant funds to people or companies to set up a business and create employment for others. The objective is to help the entrepreneurs who want to build small businesses. A proper guidance on how to run a business as well as a guide to business policies are provided to the entrepreneurs. The government also provides skill development training under the scheme.
Like, government is doing a lot for the startups because the contribution of startups in economic growth should continue and increase in the coming times. But still there are few issues related to the infrastructure or all some facilitation, single window facilitation, because sometimes the states provide single window facilitation at the larger extent, at the larger cities. But sometimes in small cities, some innovative minds are not able to implement their ideas and they are not aware about the policy of the government. That is a major point. So government should spread the awareness about this policy at the grassroots level, because sometimes people are very, very innovative at the village level or block level, but they are not able to know about the process of registration and to get benefits from the dynamic policy environment of the startups.
There are certain criteria on which a company can avail benefits of Startup India. These are: a company must be registered as a private limited company or partnership firm or a limited liability partnership. Business should not be incorporated or registered in India before 5 years. The turnover must be less than 25 crores per year. The business must be operating towards innovating something new or significantly upgrading the existing technology. The particular startup business should not be an outcome of remodeling of an existing business. In order to meet the objectives of the initiative, the government announced the action plan that addresses all aspects of the startup ecosystem. The action plan is based on three pillars: simplification and handholding, funding support and incentives, and industry academia partnership and incubation. A 19-point Startup India Action Plan has been included, under which the government provides a variety of concessions. It envisages incubation centres, easier patent filing, tax exemptions, ease of setting up businesses, a 10,000 crore rupees corpus fund, and a faster exit mechanism, among others.
Hundreds of projects have now been given loans, huge funding for startups, and recognition, I believe, has been given to nearly 15,000 units so far. So this is all the process of making it easy. This is also the process of ease of doing business. This is one of the aspects of ease of doing business and make in India. So that's the definite direction is for that. Allow them to do business, allow them to produce, allow them to innovate and help India grow and do these things in India, not in Silicon Valley or California or somewhere else.
The government has also taken the initiative to involve the industry and education in Startup India. Under this, there is a provision for providing assistance to new entrepreneurs in research and development at national and international levels. It also has special arrangements for women entrepreneurs. These programs have catalyzed the startup culture in India, and many entrepreneurs have availed the benefits of starting their own business in the country. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
So that's it from us in this edition of In Depth. Just in case you missed the television broadcast of our program, you can also watch it online on YouTube and Twitter, and you can get back to us with your feedback and suggestions as well. Thank you very much for your time.